गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स लर्न टुडे इक्विवेलेंट रेशियो। ओके, नाउ इक्विवेलेंट रेशियो, सी रेशियो वी आर राइटिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ फ्रैक्शन, रेशियो वी आर राइटिंग एज अ फ्रैक्शन। ओके, सो सिमिलरली नाउ इक्विवेलेंट रेशियो, इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन, यू नो व्हाट वी आर डूइंग फॉर इक्विवेलेंट फ्रैक्शन, सेम वे वी हैव टू डू फॉर द इक्विवेलेंट रेशियो आल्सो। ओके, नाउ सी एग्जांपल, फाइंड एनी थ्री equivalent ratios of 2:5. 2:5, it is given ratio and we have to find the equivalent ratio for the given ratio. So now ratio we can write as a fraction. Okay, so 2:5, this is given ratio. Now ratio we have to write as a fraction, that is 2/5. Now we have to find the equivalent ratio. Okay, we have to find the equivalent ratio for this given ratio. So ratio we are writing as a fraction. In fraction, now equivalent fraction, now we are finding for the numerator and denominator we have to multiply with the same number. Okay, so now if we will multiply by 1, we are going to get same ratio, 2:5 only. Now next ratio we will multiply by 2 for the denominator as well as numerator. So what we will get? 2 2s are 4, 5 2s are 10. So what we got? 4/10. 4/10 means what is the ratio? 4:10. 4:10. So what ratio we got? Equivalent ratio for 2:5. 4:10. See, for 4/10, if we will do the lowest term, we are going to get again same number. 2 2s are 4. 2 5s are 10. So what we got? 2:5 we got. So for 2:5, which ratio is equivalent? 4:10. And it is asked in the question, find 3 equivalent ratios. Okay, so now take these only, 2:5. We multiply by 2. Now write this ratio as a fraction, 2/5. Here we multiply by 2. Now here we multiply by 3. Okay, so multiply by 3. Okay, so what we will get? 3 2s are 6. 5 3s are 15. Okay, so what ratio we got now here? 6:15. 6:15. Now one more ratio we have to find. 2:5 is the given ratio. For this ratio we have to find the equivalent ratio. Okay, now write this ratio as a fraction, 2/5. Now multiply by 3 here. So here what we'll do, we'll multiply by 4. We can multiply by 5 also to get equivalent fraction. Yes, so multiplied by 4 for numerator and denominator. Okay, 2 4s are 8. 5 4s are 20. Okay, so what we got? Equivalent ratio, 8:20. Okay, what it is asking the question, find any 3 equivalent ratios of 2:5. So these are the 3 equivalent ratios of 2:5. Okay, let's see now direct variation. Okay, now see here, these are the given squares. Now side of square we'll consider S and perimeter of square we'll consider P. Perimeter so P and side of square so S. Okay, now side of square, now in this given, this square, what is the side of this square? 1 meter. What it is given? 1 meter. Side of square is given 1 meter. So what is the perimeter of this square? What is the formula to find? So what we got, perimeter of this square is 12 meter. Okay. Now observe this given table. Now see. See, side of square 1 meter, at that time perimeter of square is 4 meter. Okay, side of square is 2 meter, at that time perimeter of square is 8 meter. Side of square is 3 meter, at that time perimeter of square is 12 meter. From the above table, we observe that S varies, P is also varies. Now S upon P. S means side of square and perimeter of square. So ratio of S is to P. What is the ratio of S is to P? 1 upon 4 means 1 is to 4. Then next it is 2 is to 8, 2 upon 8. And after that 3 is to 12 means 3 upon 12. Okay, 3 upon 12 means 3 is to 12. If you will do the lowest term for this, you are going to get 1 is to 4 only ratio. Okay, 1 upon 4. See, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are 8. You are going to get the same ratio, 1 is to 4. 3 1s are 3, 3 4s are 12. Means if you will do the lowest term for this, you are going to get 1 is to 4. Now see, if a relationship exists between two variables so that their ratio is constant, then that kind of relationship is called direct variation and the ratio is called a constant of variation. Understood? See, listen again. If a relationship exists between two variables so that their ratio is constant, then that kind of relationship is called direct variation and the ratio is called a constant variation. Okay?